Sidang mahkamah pada hari ini dijalankan secara sidang video atas persetujuan semua pihak berikutan Perintah Kawalan Pergerakan. Hakim yang bersidang pada hari ini ialah Yang Ahli Hakim Datuk Norin binti Badaruddin. Petisyen pertama WA-18-695-06-2020 Nadra binti Jalaluddin.
Dan izin Yang Arif, nama saya Nadra binti Jalaluddin, pempetisyen pertama.
Dengan izin Yang Arif, nama saya Nurujana binti Abdul Rahman, peguam pemengusul yang hadir bagi pihak pempetisyen pertama. Rakan-rakan bijaksana saya yang mewakili Yang Berhormat Peguam Negara Malaysia, Majlis Peguam dan Jawatankuasa Peguam Kuala Lumpur dan Selangor adalah diperkenalkan kepada Yang Arif.
Dengan izin Yang Arif, izni Elina Zainal bagi pihak Peguam Negara Malaysia.
Dengan izin Yang Arif, saya S. Malam mewakili Majlis Peguam Malaysia.
Dengan izin Yang Arif, saya G. Preman anak laki Aris Gopal mewakili jawatankuasa Peguam Kuala Lumpur dan Selangor.
Yang Arif, hari ini telah ditetapkan untuk petisyen penerimaan masuk pempetisyen sebagai peguam bela dan peguam cara di Mahkamah Tinggi Melaya. Yang Arif, izinkan saya menceritakan sedikit latar belakang pempetisyen Nadra binti Jalaluddin. Pempetisyen telah dilahirkan pada 20 Januari 1985 di Kuala Lumpur dan beliau merupakan anak sulung daripada dua adik-beradik kepada pasangan Tuan Haji Jalaluddin bin Muhammad Zain dan Puan Hajah Nurliza binti Osman. Pempetisyen telah mendapat pendidikan di peringkat rendah di Sekolah Rendah Kebangsaan SS19 Subanjaya Selangor dan di peringkat menengah di Sekolah Menengah Kebangsaan Sivil Subanjaya Selangor. Yang Arif, pempetisyen telah memperolehi ijazah pertamanya dalam bidang pengajian undang-undang secara separuh masa selama 5 tahun di UiTM Shah Alam. Kemudian, pempetisyen meneruskan pengajian di universiti yang sama dan dianugerahkan dengan ijazah sarjana muda undang-undang dengan kepujian pada Ogos 2019. Setelah menamatkan pengajian, pempetisyen telah menjalani latihan dalam kamar di bawah penyeliaan rakan bijaksana saya Puan Suhaidar binti Muhammad Nawawi di Tetuan Idris Zaidil and Partners di Shah Alam dan menyempurnakan latihannya pada bulan Mac 2021. Yang Arif, pada hari yang berbahagia ini, pempetisyen ingin mengambil kesempatan untuk merakamkan perhargaan kepada insan-insan yang sentiasa mendoakan pempetisyen. Buat ayahanda pempetisyen Tuan Haji Jalaluddin bin Muhammad Zain dan bonda pempetisyen Puan Haji Nurliza binti Osman, tiada kata yang mampu menzahirkan rasa syukur pempetisyen kepada kedua ibu bapa pempetisyen atas segala doa, kasih sayang dan pengorbanan dalam memberikan pendidikan duniawi dan ukhrawi kepada pempetisyen. Tidak dilupakan juga kepada kedua ibu bapa mertua pempetisyen, iaitu Encik Mat Ali sekeluarga dan keluarga di Kulai, Johor. Terima kasih, tanpa doa kalian dan kasih sayang mereka, pempetisyen tidak akan berada di tahap ini. Seterusnya, buat tonggak utama pempetisyen iaitu suami pempetisyen iaitu Encik Muhammad Fazli bin Mat Ali. Terima kasih kerana sentiasa sabar memberikan perspektif yang berbeza kepada pempetisyen buntu dalam menyelesaikan masalah. Terima kasih kerana membenarkan pempetisyen memikul amanah demi mencapai cita-cita sebagai peguam bela dan peguam cara. Pempetisyen juga ingin mengucapkan terima kasih kepada adik beliau iaitu Yasmin binti Jalaluddin dan seluruh keluarga di Subanjaya. Sesungguhnya kecekalan dan kekuatan mereka adalah inspirasi kepada pempetisyen. Seterusnya, buat semua sahabat pempetisyen iaitu Nur Azlin binti Muhammad Yusof dan Nur Razihah binti Asmuni, terima kasih kerana sentiasa ada di sisi pempetisyen. Kepada rakan-rakan di Tetuan Muhammad Yusof Endot dan Associate di Subanjaya, pempetisyen ingin mengucapkan jutaan terima kasih kerana memberi peluang dan tunjuk ajar serta bimbingan dalam bidang perundangan Selama tempoh 7 tahun beliau bekerja di dari tahun 2012 sehingga 2018. Tidak lupa kepada semua rakan-rakan kelas PLK UiTM dan LW222 2017 dan 2018, perjuangan kita belum berakhir. Tidak lupa juga buat tenaga pengajar yang sudi mencurahkan ilmu tanpa mengenal penat lelah. Terima kasih untuk semua memori yang terindah. Competition juga ingin merakamkan perhargaan kepada pengajar beliau iaitu Puan Syuhaida binti Muhammad Nawawi dan warga Idris Zaidil and Partners di Shah Alam dan Kuala Lumpur yang telah banyak memberi nasihat dan tunjuk ajar kepada competition. Sepanjang tempoh latihan, competition telah didedahkan dengan pelbagai ilmu undang-undang seperti conveyancing, permohonan pembahagian harta pusaka kecil, grant of probate dan letter of administration, dan competition amat bersyukur kerana memperolehi pengalaman yang berharga tersebut. Competition juga ingin merakamkan jutaan terima kasih kepada peguam pengusul beliau iaitu saya sendiri atas kesudian untuk meluangkan masa daripada jadual yang sibuk untuk mengusulkan penerimaan masuk competition pada hari ini. Akhir sekali, buat semua kaki tangan di Tetuan Idris Zaidil and Partners di Shah Alam yang paling dekat di hati competition. Jutaan terima kasih kepada Puan Saraswati, anak perempuan Subramaniam, Encik Syahabuddin bin Ishaq dan Encik Junaidi bin Bujang kerana dengan penuh kasih sayang dan seikhlas hati memberikan tunjuk ajar dan sokongan yang tidak berbelah bahagi kepada competition. Sejak dari hari pertama, competition menyertai Idris Zaidil and Partners Shah Alam sehingga ke hari ini. Terima kasih kerana sudi setia dan komited dalam semua keadaan, baik susah maupun senang. Semoga kita kekal berharmoni dan berukhuwah seperti sebuah keluarga selamanya. Jutaan terima kasih juga petition ingin ucapkan kepada Yang Arif kerana meluangkan masa mendengar petition beliau pada hari ini. Yang Arif, saya sesungguhnya percaya bahawa segala kertas yang berkenaan adalah teratur dan rakan-rakan bijaksana saya dari badan berkenaan tiada bantahan terhadap petition ini. Oleh yang demikian, saya dengan rendah diri memohon kepada mahkamah yang mulia ini supaya competition Nadrah binti Jalaluddin diterima masuk dan didaftaraikan sebagai peguam bela dan peguam cara Mahkamah Tinggi yang Malaya.
Tiada bantahan Yang Arif.
Majlis peguam tiada bantahan Yang Arif.
Tiada bantahan Yang Arif.
Mahkamah dengan ini membenarkan permohonan competition dan menerima masuk Nadrah Jalaluddin sebagai peguam bela dan peguam cara Mahkamah Tinggi Malaya dan juga memerintahkan nama Nadrah Jalaluddin dan penerimaannya didaftaraikan oleh pendaftar.
Terima kasih Yang Arif. Saya dengan ini memohon izin mahkamah untuk membenarkan competition menyarukan jubahnya sendiri.
Dipersilakan.
Terima kasih, Yang Arif.
Terima kasih, Yang Arif.
Congratulations.
Seterusnya, petition kedua WA-18-1016-08-2020 Lee Sin Yi.
Dengan izin Yang Arif, nama saya Lee Sin Yi, petition kedua.
Yes.
Dengan izin Yang Arif, nama saya Lavinia Kumarindran, peguam pengusul yang hadir bagi pempetisyen kedua Lee Sin Yi. Rakan-rakan bijaksana saya yang mewakili Jabatan Peguam Negara, Majlis Peguam Malaysia dan Jawatan Kuasa Peguam Kuala Lumpur adalah seperti mana yang telah diperkenalkan kepada Yang Arif sebentar tadi. Yang Arif, hari ini ditetapkan untuk petisyen penerimaan masuk peguam bela dan peguam cara pempetisyen. Yang Arif, saya dengan rendah diri memohon untuk meneruskan ucapan bagi pihak competition dalam bahasa English.
Dipersilakan.
My lady, the petitioner graduated her LLB with upper second class honours from the University of London in 2017. She was awarded the degree of Masters of Law with distinction in completing with her legal practice barristers programme from the BPP University in Birmingham in 2019. She was called to the Bar of England and Wales in the same year. The petitioner, upon her arriving in Malaysia, commenced her pupillage at Mrs. Thomas Phillip in August 2020 under the direct tutelage of Mr. Matthew Thomas Phillip, her master, who has given her, she says, immense opportunities for which she's very thankful for. The petitioner was exposed to many opportunities during her 9 months, which she says, in her view, was a life as a litigator from what she has seen from all her the legal dramas on TV. She was given the opportunity to dabble her hands in drafting of course papers, meetings with clients, which she found the most challenging, and attendance in court. I would like to take this opportunity, my lady, to state here that I can attest to the fact that Thomas Phillip would have given her a strong foundation in litigation and the right teachings and exposure to litigation, as I myself was from Thomas Phillip for nearly 13 years. My early years and foundation to litigation was built and established in Thomas Phillip. I have personally known the petitioner during her pupillage when I was there, and I've known her to be very enthusiastic and a confident person. To this, my lady, the petitioner would like to thank the team at Thomas Phillip for all her support, which she has received, and for making her pupillage journey a meaningful one. She hopes that they will continue to grow stronger together. The petitioner is particularly thankful to Madhuri for her help and assistance, Jason Cheong for seeing her potential and trusting her capabilities, Han Zen and Praveena for always lighting up her workspace, and Jason Yong for his guidance and useful advice. Further, the petitioner is grateful for the people in her golden circle, for their invaluable friendship, for having so much faith in her and encouraging her along her legal journey. These people, in no particular order, are her bar school colleagues, Akila, Melissa, Jean, Kasturi, Shireen, Mikala, Shun Yong, Yon, Joel, and Lily. Last but not least, lady, the petitioner would like to express her utmost gratitude to her family, her uncles, who have been the father figure to the petitioner since her father passed away when she was 9 years old. Her mother, Madam Ong Le Moy, who has taught her to be strong and independent, and her siblings for their unconditional love. Without them, she would not have achieved what she has thus far. She would also like to thank Desmond Lowe, who has been her rock and strongest support system. She's very blessed to have him in her life. My lady, the petitioner believes that she's here today due to her perseverance and determination to achieve what she set out to do. The petitioner believes that one should have the attributes of working professionally, honestly, and most importantly, ethically. And that is what she will always ensure that she keeps to in her start of her legal practice. My lady, I hereby state that the petitioner is a fit and proper person to be admitted and enrolled as an advocate and solicitor of the High Court of Malaya. I believe that all her papers are in order, and that my learned friends from the Attorney General Chambers, the Malaysian Bar Council, and the Kuala Lumpur Bar Committee have no objections. Dengan itu, saya dengan penuh hormat memohon agar pempetisyen kedua diterima masuk dan didaftarkan sebagai seorang peguam bela dan peguam cara Mahkamah Tinggi Malaya.
Ada bantahan, Yang Arif?
Majlis Peguam tiada bantahan, Yang Arif.
Jawatan Kuasa Peguam Kuala Lumpur tidak ada bantahan, Yang Arif.
Mahkamah dengan ini membenarkan permohonan pempetisyen dan menerima masuk Li Sin Ye sebagai peguam bela dan peguam cara Mahkamah Tinggi Malaya, dan juga memerintahkan nama Li Sin Ye dan penerimaannya didaftaraikan oleh pendaftar.
Dengan izin, Yang Arif, saya memohon agar pempetisyen diberi kebenaran untuk menjubahkan dirinya sendiri.
Dipersilakan.
Terima kasih, Yang Arif.
Congratulations.
Terima kasih, Yang Arif. Much obliged.
Pempetisyen ketiga, WA-18-1029-08-2020, Lim Chee Chian.
Dengan izin Yang Arif, nama saya Lim Chi Chen, pempetition ketiga.
Yes.
Dengan izin Yang Arif, nama saya Darren Lai, Peguam Pengusul yang mewakili pempetition ketiga, Lim Chi Chen. Rakan-rakan bijaksana saya yang hadir bagi pihak yang berbahagia Peguam Negara Malaysia, Majlis Peguam Malaysia, Jawatankuasa Peguam Selangor telah diperkenalkan tadi, Yang Arif. Yang Arif, hari ini ditetapkan untuk pendengaran petisyen penerimaan masuk dan pendaftaran sebagai peguam bela dan peguam cara bagi pempetition ketiga. Dengan izin Yang Arif, saya dengan rendah diri memohon kebenaran untuk menyampaikan ucapan petisyen dalam bahasa Inggeris.
Persilakan.
Terima kasih, Yang Arif. Yang Arif, the petitioner was born on 16 December 1992 in Penang to the wonderful couple of Mr. Lim Yew Teck and Madam Tan Siew Kek. The petitioner is the youngest of the family with one brother and three sisters. The petitioner completed his early education in SJKC Li Hua before continuing his secondary education in SMK St. Mark and thereafter finished his STPM. The petitioner later obtained his first bachelor's degree of International Business Management at University Utara Malaysia, UUM, in the year 2016. After a year of working, the petitioner decided to pursue his dream and read law at Multimedia University, more commonly known as MMU, where he graduated with a second-class honours. Upon completion of his degree studies, the petitioner then had the honour of completing his pupillage under the tutelage of my learned friend, Mr. Lim Sun Wei of Messrs. Lim, Tan and Co. The petitioner, my lady, always had the ambitions of being a lawyer since childhood. Although the petitioner's family was not wealthy, the petitioner's father, who worked hard as a factory operator, takes education seriously and believes that education can change a person's destiny. These ethics have etched firmly in the petitioner's heart throughout. Therefore, the petitioner would like to express his sincerest appreciation to his parents' absolute affection and support to pursue his dreams, which thereby aspires the petitioner to be the lawyer who fights for the rights of the people and to seek justice for all without fear or favour. During the crucial 9 months of chambering period, the petitioner was grateful to learn from his pupil master and the partners of the firm, Mr. Benjamin Tan, and to practice in various fields of the law. For example, criminal litigation, civil litigation, conveyancing, and even corporate matters. The petitioner will always look up to his master, who never compromises on professional ethics and emphasizes the importance of inculcating interpersonal skills. On this momentous day, the petitioner would like to express his sincerest love and gratitude to his parents, who never cease to believe in him even in the face of adversity, and their undivided support, which fuels the petitioner to achieve greater heights in life, all of which were essential elements to each of the petitioner's milestones made thus far in his life. The petitioner would also like to extend his gratitude to his girlfriend for the love and support throughout his journey in law. Next, the petitioner would also like to record his utmost appreciation to his pupil master, Mr. Lim Sun Wei, and the firm's partner, Mr. Benjamin Tan, for it has been a privilege to receive their mentorship and invaluable advice. At this extent, my lady, I would like to add that Mr. Lim and Mr. Tan were my chambering mates more than 10 years ago, and it is my honor today to move their pupil's call. I trust the petitioner would have learned a great deal from this dynamic duo, and would continue to develop as the petitioner has been retained. Last but not least, the petitioner also thanks his colleagues at Messrs. Lim, Tan & Co, as well as all his friends in MMU and the Wonderland Group for their encouragement and support. Sounds like a wonderful group to be in. Yang Arif, with that, I believe the petitioner is a fit and proper person to be admitted as an advocate and solicitor of the High Court of Malaya. Yang Arif, saya percaya kertas-kertas kausa pempetisyen adalah teratur. Saya juga percaya wakil-wakil dari Peguam Negara Malaysia, Majlis Peguam Malaysia dan jawatankuasa Peguam Selangor tiada bantahan. Saya dengan rendah diri memohon mahkamah yang mulia ini agar pempetisyen Lim Chi Chen diterima masuk dan didaftarkan sebagai peguam bela dan peguam cara Mahkamah Tinggi Malaya.
Ada bantahan, Yang Arif?
Majlis Peguam tiada bantahan, Yang Arif.
Tiada bantahan, Yang Arif.
Mahkamah dengan ini membenarkan permohonan pempetisyen dan menerima masuk Lim Chi Chien sebagai peguam bela dan peguam cara Mahkamah Tinggi Malaya dan juga memerintahkan nama Lim Chi Chien dan penerimaannya didaftaraikan oleh pendaftar.
Terima kasih Yang Arif. Saya mohon Yang Arif agar pempetisyen menjubahkan dirinya sendiri.
Persilakan.
Terima kasih Arif.
Congratulations.
Terima kasih Arif. Much obliged.
Petition 8-1049-08/20-20 Angeline Liu Suk Hui.
Dengan izin Yang Arif, nama saya Angeline Liu Suk Hui, pempetisyen keempat.
Yes.
Dengan izin Yang Arif, saya Li Tiong Hui, merupakan peguam pengusul bagi pihak pempetisyen keempat Angeline Liu Suk Hui pada hari ini Yang Arif. Dan rakan-rakan bijaksana saya yang mewakili Jabatan Peguam Negara Malaysia, Majlis Peguam Malaysia dan Jawatan Peguam Kuala Lumpur yang telah diperkenalkan sebentar tadi. Yang Arif, hari ini adalah petisyen untuk penerimaan masuk pempetisyen sebagai peguam bela dan peguam cara ke Mahkamah Tinggi Malaysia. Saya ingin memohon kebenaran Yang Arif untuk berhujah dalam bahasa Inggeris, Yang Arif.
Dipersilakan.
My lady, may I introduce the petitioner Angeline Liu Suk Hui. The petitioner was born in Malacca on the 19th December 1996 and is the first child of Mr. Liao Yingfei and Madam Ang Yok Hui. The petitioner read law at University of Malaya where she graduated with second class honours in the year 2019. The petitioner then commenced her pupillage in Mrs. Raja, Darrell and Low under the tutelage of my learned friend, Ms. Chong Mei Mei. The petitioner also takes this opportunity to express her utmost gratitude to her parents for their immense sacrifice and unconditional love throughout her education and for their constant encouragement, not forgetting her sister, Ms. Esther Liao, for her unending support in times of need. The petitioner would like to thank her pupil master, Ms. Chong Mei Mei, for providing her with invaluable advice and mentorship throughout her pupillage. The petitioner would also like to extend her gratitude to Ms. Ng Sai Ying for her infinite patience and wisdom in guiding the petitioner during her pupillage days, up till now and for the days to come. From the bottom of her heart, the petitioner wishes to thank Alvin Sim for being on her side when the going gets tough, and for his unwavering love, patience, support, and humor. The petitioner also would like to thank Su Xian, Suzy, Yishen, Jia Zheng, Winnie, Ziyi, Yunlu, Winnie's, and Melanie for their steadfast friendship. My lady, I believe that the petitioner is a fit and proper person to be admitted and enrolled as an advocate and solicitor of this honorable court. I believe all the petitioner's papers are in order and that my learned friends from the Attorney General Chambers, the Bar Council and the Kuala Lumpur Bar Committee respectively have no objections to this motion.
Tiada bantahan Yang Arif.
Tiada bantahan Yang Arif.
Tiada bantahan Yang Arif.
Okay, dengan izin Yang Arif, saya dengan ini mengusulkan Mahkamah Yang Mulia ini untuk menerima masuk dan mendaftarai pempetisyen Angeline Liu Suk Hui sebagai peguam bela dan peguam cara Mahkamah Tinggi Malaya.
Mahkamah dengan ini membenarkan permohonan pempetisyen dan menerima masuk Angeline Liu Suk Hui sebagai peguam bela dan peguam cara Mahkamah Tinggi Malaya dan juga memerintahkan nama Angeline Liu Suk Hui dan penerimaannya didaftaraikan oleh pendaftar.
Terima kasih, Arif. Saya memohon kebenaran mahkamah untuk pempetisyen menjubahkan dirinya sendiri.
Dipersilakan.
Terima kasih Yang Arif.
Congratulations.
Terima kasih Yang Arif.
Pempetisyen kelima WA-18-1102-08-2020 Nina Nur Kamilia Isha binti Arif.
Dengan izin Yang Arif, nama saya Nina Nur Kamilia Isha binti Arif, pempetisyen kelima.
Yes.
Dengan izin Yang Arif, saya Magdalena binti Bahri, peguam pengusul yang mewakili pempetisyen kelima, Nina Nur Kamilia Isha binti Arif pada hari ini. Yang Arif turut hadir pada hari ini rakan-rakan bijaksana saya yang masing-masing mewakili yang berbahagia peguam negara Malaysia dan pihak Majlis Peguam Malaysia juga jawatankuasa peguam Kuala Lumpur yang telah pun diperkenalkan sebentar tadi. Yang Arif, hari ini ditetapkan untuk pendengaran petisyen penerimaan masuk pempetisyen kelima sebagai peguam bela dan peguam cara di Mahkamah Tinggi Malaya. Dengan izin Yang Arif, terlebih dahulu saya ingin memperkenalkan pempetisyen bernama Nina Nur Kamilia Isha binti Arif. Pempetisyen dilahirkan di Johor Bahru pada 14 Mac 1997 dan merupakan anak bongsu kepada Encik Haji Arif bin Kasim dan Puan Rozana Abdul Ghani. Pempetisyen telah memulakan pendidikannya di Sekolah Kebangsaan Taman Daya Johor Bahru dan telah meneruskan pelajarannya di sebuah sekolah berasrama penuh di Kolej Tunku Kursiah di Negeri Sembilan selama 5 tahun yang mana pempetisyen terpaksa menetap jauh dari keluarga. Sepanjang berjauhan dari keluarga, pempetisyen mengakui menghadapi pelbagai kesukaran dan cabaran ketika menuntut di Kolej Tunku Kursiah sepanjang 5 tahunnya di sana. Selepas menduduki SPM, cabaran terbesar pempetisyen adalah untuk memilih perjalanan kerjaya yang sesuai dan terbaik untuk pempetisyen. Berbekalkan sokongan dan dorongan bapa pempetisyen yang telah memberi cadangan kepada pempetisyen untuk cuba meneruskan pelajarannya dalam Foundation Indo di Management and Science University sebagai stepping stone dalam perjalanan kerjayanya. Yang Arif, sepanjang menghadiri kuliah yang disediakan, pempetisyen telah membuat yang terbaik dan segala usaha keras pempetisyen telah melayakkannya mendapat anugerah dekan dalam setiap semester. Dan ini telah membuatkan pempetisyen semakin yakin dan committed untuk meneruskan sarjana muda dalam bidang undang-undang Bachelor in Law Honours LLB di Multimedia University Melaka selama 4 tahun. Setelah menamatkan pengajiannya, pempetisyen meneruskan latihan dalam kamar dan merupakan pelatih dalam kamar kepada Encik Muhammad Iftitah bin Abdul Latif di Tuan Abdul Rahman and Partners. Dan sepanjang tempoh latihan ini, pempetisyen telah menimba ilmu dan pengalaman dalam pelbagai aspek. Di sini, pempetisyen ingin mengucapkan jutaan terima kasih kepada masternya, Encik Muhammad Iftitah yang telah memberikan pempetisyen peluang untuk melayari dan mempelajari selok-belok sebagai seorang pengawal undang-undang dan mengajar pempetisyen banyak perkara yang mana tidak mungkin pempetisyen akan peroleh di tempat lain. Yang Arif, pempetisyen juga memanjatkan syukur kepada Allah SWT kerana dengan izinnya pempetisyen berada di sini pada hari ini. Dan pempetisyen berharap agar pempetisyen dapat menjalankan tugasnya sebagai seorang peguam dengan sebaik mungkin. Yang Arif, pempetisyen juga ingin mengambil kesempatan ini untuk berterima kasih kepada ibu dan bapa kesayangan Encik Arif bin Kasim dan Puan Rozana binti Abdul Ghani yang telah memberikan semangat, kasih sayang yang tidak terhingga, yang telah terus mempercayai dan mendorong pempetisyen agar tidak berputus asa dan tidak pernah putus mendoakan kejayaan pempetisyen. Terutamanya kepada ibu pempetisyen Yang Arif, yang mana dalam kesempatan ini dengan izin Yang Arif, pempetisyen ingin merangkapkan kata-kata khas ini buat ibunya. Mami, thank you for being so strong until today and for still being on my side even when you thought you couldn't after being diagnosed with lung cancer last 6 years. And thank you for being here to witness this day with me along with Papa and everyone. Seterusnya, pempetisyen juga berterima kasih kepada kakak dan abang-abangnya iaitu Abang Bert, Kak Nas, Abang Amilin, Angah Tash, Kak Tasha, Abang Nis, Abang Harith dan Imani yang tidak putus memberi sokongan dan kasih sayang kepada pempetisyen. Di sini juga Yang Arif, pempetisyen ingin mengucapkan terima kasih kepada guru-gurunya semasa di Kolej Tunku Kursiah, terutamanya Miss VP yang sentiasa ada di samping pempetisyen di masa sulitnya sepanjang 5 tahun di sana. Pensyarah-pensyarah semasa di Management and Science University dan Multimedia University, Madam Lily dan Madam Asfarina yang telah memberi tunjuk ajar dan yang sentiasa memberi nasihat kepada pempetisyen semasa pengajiannya. Pada rakan-rakan baiknya semasa di universiti, Putri, Chacha, Angeline, Farisha, Faizul dan Idin yang bukan sahaja memberi kenangan manis sepanjang pengajian tetapi juga telah memudahkan hari-harinya di universiti dan juga rakan-rakan baiknya Syaza, Arisa, Nisa, Ika, Min, Andrea dan Zuhar yang telah ada bersama pempetisyen selama ini. Dan tidak lupa kepada rakan-rakan sekerjanya di Abdul Rahman and Partners yang telah memberi pertolongan semangat dan tunjuk ajar kepada competition sepanjang latihan dalam kamarnya. Akhir sekali yang Arif. Competition juga ingin berterima kasih kepada setiap insan di mana namanya tidak disertakan dalam ucapan ini yang pernah memberi impak dalam kehidupan competition selama ini. Yang Arif, dengan itu saya sesungguhnya percaya bahawa segala dokumentasi dan representasi surat cara competition adalah lengkap dan teratur. Dan competition adalah seorang yang berkelayakan menurut Akta Profesion Undang-Undang 1976. Saya juga dengan ini percaya bahawa rakan-rakan bijaksana saya yang mewakili semua badan-badan berkenaan tidak mempunyai sebarang bantahan terhadap petisyen ini.
Tiada bantahan yang Arif.
Tiada bantahan yang Arif.
Tiada bantahan yang Arif.
Dengan izinnya Arif, oleh yang demikian, saya dengan rendah diri memohon kepada Mahkamah Yang Mulia ini agar pempetisyen Nina Nur Kamilia Aisyah binti Arif diterima masuk dan didaftarai sebagai peguam bela dan peguam cara di Mahkamah Tinggi Malaya. Terima kasih, Yang Arif.
Mahkamah dengan ini membenarkan permohonan pempetisyen dan menerima masuk Nina Nur Kamila Aisyah binti Arif sebagai peguam bela dan peguam cara Mahkamah Tinggi Malaya, dan juga memerintahkan nama Nina Nur Kamilia Aisyah binti Arif dan penerimaannya didaftaraikan oleh pendaftar.
Terima kasih, Arif. Dengan izin yang Arif, di sini saya memohon kebenaran Mahkamah Yang Mulia ini selaras dengan norma baru untuk pempetisyen menjubahkan dirinya sendiri, Yang Arif.
Dipersilakan.
Terima kasih, Yang Arif.
Congratulations.
Competition ke-6 WE18-1125-09/2020 Kassandra Lee Zi Hui.
Dengan izin Yang Arif, nama saya Kassandra Lee Zi Hui, competition ke-6.
Yes.
Dengan izin Yang Arif, saya Nicholas Hossein Pin, hadir bagi pihak competition ke-6 hari ini, Kassandra Lee Zi Hui. Rakan-rakan bijaksana saya yang masing-masing mewakili Jabatan Peguam Negara, Majlis Peguam Malaysia dan Jawatan Kuasa Peguam Kuala Lumpur telah pun dikenalkan tadi. Dengan izin Yarif, saya dengan rendah diri memohon kebenaran untuk meneruskan ucapan dalam bahasa Inggeris. Much obliged, my lady.
Persilakan, yes.
Much obliged, my lady. My lady, may I introduce your humble petitioner today, Kassandra Lee Zi Hui, who hails from the land below the wind, Sabah. Born in Kota Kinabalu on 24th of June 1997, the petitioner is the youngest child of Mr. Lee Chan Woon and Madam Tan Mui Kim. The petitioner have two older brothers. Yarif, your petitioner informs me that as a child, she was very loud and outspoken. In fact, growing up, she was often told that she had the quote-unquote necessary traits of a lawyer, seeing how she always fought back against her siblings, or in other words, her brothers. The petitioner also informs me that her brothers also taught her that she has to work for her own achievements. And hence the petitioner, having completed her secondary education at Kian Kok Middle School in the pure science stream, had considered pursuing a science degree. However, the petitioner weighed her options and chose to pursue law instead, because she informs me that pursuing a science degree would require her to do maths. So I'm sure the petitioner will be surprised, Yang Arif, to find out that there are indeed some math involved when you become a lawyer. especially when we calculate judgment interest, which I hate. My lady, the petitioner's journey to be a lawyer began in the Multimedia University, where she studied her foundation and then continued to read law there. At the uni, she served as a director of a musical organized by the Christian Fellowship there. She then graduated with second class honors in the year 2020, and in the same year began her pupilage at Mrs. Low Al-Jafri and Associates under the tutelage of my learned friend and college mate, Ms. Sharifa Nadia Al-Jafri. Throughout her pupilage, the petitioner had gained invaluable insights into the practice of law and have undergone a fulfilling journey with ample growth and new experiences despite the pandemic. She fondly recalls the experience of being given the opportunity to be involved in a striking out application all the way from its commencement up to the hearing of the appeal at the High Court. Yeah, Arif, on this memorable day, the petitioner would like to take this opportunity to express her heartfelt gratitude towards the people who have been her constant support throughout this journey. Firstly, to both her beloved parents, Mr. and Mrs. Lee, who have shaped her to be the person that she is today, providing endless support physically, emotionally, and of course, financially. Petitioner wishes to thank her parents for not being the typical Asian parents, as she puts it, and letting her have a balance of fun and freedom and hard work for her studies. Without them, petitioner would not have been able to achieve the milestone today. And not forgetting her two brothers, whom she's been fighting with since young, but whom she credits as instrumental in developing better argument skills and, her words not mine, tactics, as well as to convey her points clearly in her work. With all said and done, petitioner is very grateful to both her brothers, whom I'm sure are present today on YouTube, for taking care of her through thick and thin. Petitioner would also like to thank her cousins, Karen and Aaron, for supporting her in Peninsula Malaysia as she went through law school and her pupilage. The petitioner is grateful for the little things that they do and the time spent together. And furthermore, and of course, the petitioner would also like to extend her utmost gratitude to her pupil master, Ms. Nadia, for her patience and constant guidance throughout her pupilage. And not only did Nadia taught her on the fundamentals of legal practice, but also imparted in her nuggets of wisdom for life. Petitioner also records her appreciation to Ms. Lau Chi Ching of Mrs. Lau Al-Jafri and Associates, who has taught her that precision and consistency are key to being a good practitioner, which I fully agree with. The petitioner would also like to specially thank all her friends from her university days for always being there and making the tough times more bearable, and most importantly, for bearing with her during exam season. There are too many of them here to name all of them, but the petitioner believes that they themselves know who they are. And lastly, and most importantly, the petitioner would like to thank God for the opportunities given to her and for the people placed in different stages of her life. The petitioner knows that pursuing a legal career is a marathon and not a sprint, she says. But she is glad to have chosen to start this journey. She quotes Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., who said, and I quote, "Take the first step in faith. You don't have to see the whole staircase, but just take the first step." I'm sure that with the petitioner's enthusiasm, she will climb this seemingly never-ending staircase with zeal and not give up. And so with that, my lady, it is my great honor and privilege to be here today to move the call. And I very verily believe that the petitioner is a fit and proper person to be admitted and enrolled as an advocate and solicitor of the High Court of Malay. I believe that the petitioner's papers are in order and that my learned friends from the respective authorities and organizations have no objections to this motion.
Tiada bantahan yang Arif.
Tiada bantahan yang Arif.
Tiada bantahan yang Arif.
Oleh yang demikian, yang Arif, saya dengan bangga dan rendah diri ingin memohon untuk satu perintah bahawa pempetisyen Cassandra Lee Zuhui diterima masuk dan didaftaraihkan sebagai seorang peguam bela dan peguam cara di Mahkamah Tinggi Malaya.
Mahkamah dengan ini membenarkan permohonan pempetisyen dan menerima masuk Cassandra Lee Zuhui sebagai peguam bela dan peguam cara Mahkamah Tinggi Malaya dan juga memerintahkan nama Cassandra Lee Zuhui dan penerimaannya didaftaraikan oleh pendaftar.
Terima kasih, Yang Arif. Saya juga memohon kebenaran mahkamah untuk membenarkan pempetisyen menjubahkan dirinya sendiri.
Dipersilakan.
Terima kasih, Yang Arif.
Congratulations.
Thank you, Yang Arif.
Pempetisyen terakhir. Pempetisyen nombor 7-18-18-1138-09-2020 Ko Jia Yuan.
Dengan izin, Yang Arif. Nama saya Ko Jia Yuan, pempetisyen ke-7.
Yes.
Dengan izin, Yang Arif, saya Celine Chaladure, peguam pengusul yang mewakili Ko Jia Yuan, iaitu pempetisyen ketujuh. Rakan-rakan bijaksana saya yang masing-masing mewakili yang berbahagia Jabatan Peguam Negara, Majlis Peguam Malaysia dan Jawatan Kuasa Peguam Kuala Lumpur telah pun diperkenalkan sebentar tadi. Dengan izin, Yang Arif, saya memohon kebenaran Yang Arif untuk meneruskan ucapan saya dalam bahasa Inggeris.
Persilakan.
My lady, your petitioner Ko Jia Yuan, fondly known to his friends as Benjamin, read law at University Malaya and graduated with a first-class honours in the year 2020. Upon graduation, your petitioner read in the chambers of Mrs. Dunn Partnership under the tutelage of my very good friend and learned friend, Mr. Fu Jun Liang. Yang Arif, your petitioner finds great pleasure in the advancement of knowledge in the law by voraciously reading all material relating to the law. Despite performing well in law school and being commended for his aptitude in the law, your petitioner constantly questioned himself as to his suitability in the practice of law. This questioning was integral in his search for his true north in life. Despite the petitioner not being a morning person and the challenges of rising early and fulfilling his duties to his master at the firm, which sometimes were difficult, time-consuming, the petitioner began to feel a growing sense of excitement in fulfilling each task, no matter how small or large. The petitioner began to understand that everyone had a role to play in the delivery of legal services to the client, and in so doing, being a small part of one of the three pillars of justice. Despite this journey, the petitioner is mindful of the advice of his lecturer, Associate Professor Madame Zuraida Rustam Shahroom, which was, and I quote, "Do not jump on the bandwagon, do not succumb to peer pressure," end of quote, and tries to abide by that and hopes to continue this journey in that vein. Today, your petitioner also takes this opportunity to wish and express his utmost gratitude to his pillars of strength, his family, to whom he is indebted for their love. His parents, Mr. Ko Kiat Woi and Madam Lee Kun Kyok's guidance have molded him into the person he is today. Your petitioner also thanks his brother, Ko Jia Hearn, for his unwavering support. Petitioner would also like to thank his uncle, Lee Ki Tai, and aunt, Fong So Lan, who raised him until the age of 6. And on this memorable occasion, both of them were advocates and solicitors of this honorable court and have inspired him to become a lawyer. Your petitioner would like to thank his pupil master, Mr. Fu Junliang, for his untiring guidance throughout his pupilage. He aspires to be as sharp and eloquent a lawyer as his pupil master is someday. To the partners, associates, employees, and colleagues in Mrs. Gan Partnership, your petitioner wishes to say a big thank you. My lady, I believe that your petitioner is a fit and proper person to be admitted and enrolled as an advocate and solicitor of the High Court of Malaya, and that the papers are in order. I also believe that my learned friends from the relevant bodies have no objections to this petition.
Tiada bantahan, Yang Arif.
Majlis Peguam, tiada bantahan, Yang Arif.
Jawatan Kuasa Peguam Kuala Lumpur, tiada bantahan, Yang Arif.
Yang Arif, saya dengan rendah dirinya memohon kepada mahkamah yang mulia ini agar pempetisyen ketujuh, Ho Jia Yuan, diterima masuk dan didaftaraikan sebagai seorang peguam bela dan peguam cara Mahkamah Tinggi Malaya.
Mahkamah dengan ini membenarkan permohonan pempetisyen dan menerima masuk Ho Jia Yuan sebagai peguam bela dan peguam cara Mahkamah Tinggi Malaya dan juga memerintahkan nama Ko Jia Yuan dan penerimaannya didaftaraikan oleh pendaftar.
Terima kasih, Yang Arif. Saya memohon kebenaran mahkamah yang mulia ini untuk pempetisyen menjubahkan dirinya sendiri.
Dipersilakan.
Terima kasih, Yang Arif.
Tahniah.
Terima kasih, Yang Arif.
Dengan ini, saya menjemput Yang Arif Hakim untuk memberikan ucapan.
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. And a very good morning. Puan Izni Elina, representative of the Attorney General's Chambers, Madam S. Malar, representative of the Malaysian Bar Council, Mr. Primam, representative of the Kuala Lumpur Bar Committee. Peguam-peguam pengusul yang bijaksana, terima kasih kerana berkorban masa untuk hadir pada hari pagi ini untuk sama-sama merealisasikan impian dan cita-cita pempetisyen-pempetisyen pada hari ini. Nama anda akan terpahat dan akan disebut dalam sejarah hidup para pempetisyen sehingga ke akhir hayat mereka. Anda, Dengan komitmen anda pada hari ini, anda sebenarnya telah menunjukkan contoh yang terbaik mengenai komitmen dan tanggungjawab yang perlu dilaksanakan dengan penuh dedikasi, hormat dan kesedaran akan keadilan. Anda telah melakukan keadilan kepada competition pada hari ini. Izinkan saya meneruskan ucapan saya dalam bahasa Inggeris. Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the Malaysian judiciary, I would like to take this opportunity to congratulate all petitioners on your admission as advocates and solicitor of the High Court of Malaya. You have come to the final chapter in achieving your ambition. It is time for you to be prepared to face all the challenges and bittersweet of this profession. Welcome to the arena. I would like also to congratulate your parents and your loved ones who had sacrificed a lot to get you to where you are today. Congratulations as well to the masters who had willingly and diligently shared their legal knowledge during the 9 months of pupillage period to all the petitioners on the reality of this profession. I believe the petitioners are also taught about what to do, the do's and the don'ts of this profession. Not to forget to all family members and friends who have been giving the unwavering support to all petitioners throughout this journey. Ladies and gentlemen, today marks history, not only for the petitioners who are admitted and enrolled as advocates and solicitors of the High Court of Malaya, but also for the Malaysian judiciary in conducting these momentous proceedings virtually. This is an initiative of the Malaysian judiciary to ensure that the petitioners are able to continue their careers in the legal fraternity. And this is the new norm that is to be adapted and adopted by all parties in facing the COVID-19 pandemic. Ladies and gentlemen, the legal profession, they say, is a noble and respected profession. And I agree. Since the beginning of civilized nation until today, this profession has been given great trust in their roles and responsibilities in implementing and upholding justice. Undoubtedly, this field has obstacles and challenges for its practitioners, especially during this period where the whole world is fighting the pandemic outbreak, which impacts the world's economy, including the legal profession in Malaysia. As such, it can be said that the current situation shows that the average young lawyers will face the challenges of a competitive job market. Be that as it may, I believe that no matter what challenges and obstacles arises, it will not be a hindrance for this profession to continuously grow, and the service of the petitioners are still needed. In addition, the COVID-19 pandemic has also changed the lifestyle and method of communication to a new norm that needs to be practiced from now on. In the context of the legal field in Malaysia, most cases are now being conducted online in response to the government's call to curb the spread of the pandemic. Therefore, we have to ensure that we are all well equipped to face whatever obstacle that may occur, especially in empowering knowledge and skills regarding information technology. In the current competitive situation as young lawyers, I hope your work routine is not only from 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. and not reluctant to work earlier or later than you should. Yes, Mr. Koh? Your perseverance and commitment in performing the given task reflects who you are. Hence, my advice is that the petitioners should try to improve all the weaknesses during your services earnestly. Love the profession you chose. You wanted to be a lawyer, don't you? You gave up being doctors, even though you're from the science streams, most of you. So, work with full commitment and responsibility and be honest in everything you do. It should be emphasized that a lawyer is also an officer of the court and has the duty to assist the court in upholding justice. the world is now looking more on the doctors, you know, as frontliners, as the profession, as a noble profession that contributes to society. Well, you all have a role to play, that this profession will also be enabled, will also able to contribute to the society. In one way or another, we also must prove that we are also the frontliners in the country. Now, a lawyer needs to ensure that he performs his role well when dealing with the court. A lawyer who is well prepared with his case will smoothen the court process. It is my hope that young lawyers take cognizance about legal ethics, for it reflects this profession. Be mindful of your speech and behavior, and do not tarnish the profession. Read and understand the Act, regulations, and rules related to this profession to ensure that every lawyer knows about their rights and limitations in the administration of justice. Be truthful and be honest to the law. As young lawyers, try to learn from a more senior or experienced lawyer. Find time and observe how they handle cases with maturity, wisdom, and prudence. We have a few of them here, or all of them here. I have witnessed myself their performance in court. So this will indirectly help you when handling cases, especially the type of case, applicable law, as well as your advocacy skills. Lack of continuous training, exposure, and legal knowledge in this profession will make a lawyer less experienced and less achievement. The high numbers of law graduates nowadays is not an excuse for the focus on training and teaching to become less important. As I have said earlier, Ms. Malar, Mr. Preman, we hope that the Malaysian Bar Council will continuously provide training for its members, especially for these young lawyers. Ladies and gentlemen, a high level of integrity, patience, and discipline should always be a key principle in this profession. Do not make this profession merely to reap profits by neglecting the actual purpose why this profession is chosen at first, and tarnish the image of this profession by the behavior of irresponsible lawyers. As young lawyers, you play an important role in maintaining high standards in shaping the future of the Malaysian Bar Council. Observe the ethics and legal responsibilities in order to instill public confidence towards this profession. Don't let the public make a joke out of this profession. In all cases, it is a shared responsibility between the bar and the judiciary to uphold the rule of law and to ensure that the justice system is served in transparent and fair manner. Last but not least, be a lawyer who is dedicated. Don't just be an ordinary one, be an exceptional one, full of integrity, ethical, and high discipline, and strive to improve skills and knowledge in this profession for the better future, not only for the petitioners, but also this profession. Hopefully one day you will be able to appear in court, and the judges at court for that matter will be very pleased to see you. You know, that gesture of, he or she is here. Not, he or she is here. If you know what I mean. So ladies and gentlemen, for your very kind attention, thank you very much. Congratulations again. I wish you all the best in your future endeavor. Wabillahi taufik wal hidayah. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thank you.